Welcome to my new and improved boy to girl tutorial, or really just a makeup tutorial for people that want to learn how to do makeup. It's very straightforward. I'll have all of the stuff that I use linked below. I'm gonna try and keep it quick and simple, especially because I have to go live in 20 minutes. Twitch description, very cool, very pog. Anyways, this tutorial is for anyone that's kind of just trying to learn beginner's makeup or kind of like that e-girl style of makeup. Especially if you're a guy trying to look like a woman, this tutorial works very well. I will say, really quickly, some of my biggest factors to my success are using Snapcam filters, getting my eyebrows done, getting my eyelashes done, which aren't done right now, and having long hair, and also lighting. So, not everyone's going to have the same results, but this will definitely make you look very poggers, very feminine, especially if you get your eyebrows done. Please get your eyebrows done. Also, just a little bit of a disclaimer to all the gamers out there. I'm gonna be doing a really bad job at my makeup because I have the mirror position to where you can see kind of what I'm doing. So my makeup will look really bad because I can't see in the mirror when I'm doing this. I'm gonna have to look through the mirror onto the monitor, so yeah. Anyways, I have a couple of options for those, for some people out there. I use a new foundation now because my old tutorial, this one's outdated. Feel free to watch it if you want. It's just, I do my makeup a little bit differently now and I know a little bit more about makeup, so I use a brand new one. So we have a couple options here for foundation for you gamers. My personal favorite is this Fit Me foundation. It's very pog. Check this out. It's a liquid foundation. Make sure to get a foundation brush if you're going to be using the Fit Me stuff. I'll have my foundation brush and the Fit Me concealer listed. Previously, I was using this concealer stick as my foundation that I can't really find. Now, I've transferred to liquid foundation, and I cannot stress enough how much I love liquid foundation. It makes everything just look so much smoother. It really helps me give off that more feminine look, especially because as a guy who has horrible acne, let me just give you a quick showcase on how bad my acne is. And I'm sweating, so my face is gonna be really red. Look at this acne. You can't really see it. Whatever. I got really bad acne scars, so using liquid foundation is a pretty big must for me. So I definitely recommend this Fit Me liquid foundation. I'm gonna be using, for the sake of this video, this darker, I think this is the ivory one. I'm not sure. I'm gonna be using a darker foundation so that you can see me putting on my foundation. I usually use this lighter porcelain one because it matches my skin tone just a little bit better. But when I'm in heavy lighting and it's very white lighting, I tend to go for the darker, more tan colors for my skin because the white lighting kind of evens it out. Lighting makes a big play on how your makeup is going to look. So I do advise going for a foundation. If you're doing it for a camera, depending on your lighting, I advise going for a foundation that is a little bit darker than your skin tone if you're doing really light lighting, or if you're just doing traditional, no fancy nothing crazy IRL stuff, I recommend doing a foundation that's closer, the closest you can get to your skin tone and not caking your face. I cake my face with foundation when I'm doing it for camera. If you're just doing IRL stuff, I don't advise caking your face with foundation. I usually use foundations for touch-ups. I think it gives a more smooth and natural look. I think going for natural is very important, at least for me. You don't have to go for natural if you're going for more of a doll face. You can cake your face and liquid foundation. Go for it. It kind of looks okay on camera sometimes. Anyways, let's get started with the foundation. I'm just gonna speed through it really quickly and kind of show you where I put it along the way. So eyes here. Also, hello, can you see me? No, there, you can see me. I can't see myself, but you can kind of see me. This is Editing Cal. This is a little tip for people that are just trying to look better on camera, and especially for people that are guys trying to come off as a woman like me, or trans girls, whatever, you get the point. I will be making a dedicated tutorial for specifically people who are masculine trying to go for a much more feminine look or even pass entirely as a woman. There will be a dedicated tutorial for that coming out soon. This is mainly just my makeup tutorial. I wanted to quickly mention that angles make a massive difference in the way you look, and this is a perfect example. I was just editing and I was like, wow, I don't even look like myself from this angle. It's because angles, lighting, all this stuff make a massive role. This is a very odd angle to be viewing me at, and there's almost no proper lighting because I'm turned completely away from my lights almost. So I think this is just a great example to show that just from something as small as this, you can really begin to notice that, wow, angles and lighting make a massive difference. And this is what I always talk about when I say angles and lighting make a massive difference. This is a perfect example. Anyways, sorry for the interruption. Have fun watching. Hello. I advise getting a foundation brush if I didn't mention that already. You see foundation brush? Very poggers. These are very useful. Mine is Flat Top Kabuki. I will link it in the description. I'm gonna have to go find it though. Don't know where it's at. Anyways, here is my Fit Me Ivory. I believe it's ivory. I really don't know. All right, so if you're really very beginner, this is very nice. What I like to do, especially if you're a very beginner, because application is kind of hard with these Fit Me ones. That's the only thing I kind of hate. It's hard to get the foundation out. I dump it upside down and I shake it. I shake it. Make sure it's closed. Do not make them. If you spill this everywhere, it's going to be. Anyways, I open it and there we go. We have a little bit on the top. You can't really see. Now it's all at the top. And what I like to do is I just kind of like rub it barely on the brush. You do not want to get a lot if you're not caking your face. I'm not caking my face for the sake of the tutorial. I'm just going to kind of show you my key application spots. What I like to do is, if you're a very masculine man like me and you have very red skin tone, what I do is I just go over the really red spots. And instead of doing blush, because I have very red irritated skin up here, I don't do blush. I just don't apply makeup there. I think it's very relative to what your skin tone is. Where you don't want as red and blotchy skin, if you want your face to look smooth, I advise applying it all over your face. But for me, I just kind of apply it where it's necessary. My acne scars, cover those along my jawline. I definitely think going along your jawline is very important, especially as a guy, because if you kind of blend it, it makes your jawline a little bit less pronounced, which is what I try to go for. As someone who's trying to get a more feminine look, I try to hide my jawline a little bit. I'm not good at contouring. I'm pretty at contouring. So since I can't contour, I just try to kind of mask the facial features that make me look masculine. I also don't like to do nose blush. Nose blush looks really cute. If you want to do nose blush, go for it. But I usually try to hide my nose, as I have a pretty chunky boy right there. If I just pop off this filter, that's a pretty big nose. So I try to put a lot of foundation around my nose to kind of hide it. Anyways, we're just going to go on my jawline. You can see I'm kind of just applying it along my jawline. I'm going to take off my headset. And I just go on my jawline. And then on my chin, what I do is I just go all over my chin and around my lips. I usually don't do lip makeup. If you want to do lipstick, there's some great tutorials out there. You really just need lip liner and some lipstick. But I don't do lipstick personally. I don't think I need lipstick. But as you can see, I'm just gonna kind of go over the red spots on my face until I can't see it on camera. If you're doing this in real life, for real life makeup, I do my makeup for camera. They're a little bit different. You're just gonna wanna go and do your foundation until your foundation looks how you want. You can cake your face if you want. I usually don't cake my face. I just kind of go over the areas that look a little bit too red. And the great thing about this foundation brush here is you usually don't have to use a little blending sponge like this. You don't really need to get one of these if you're using the right brush. However, I do advise get a nice beauty blender. I have cheaped out on my beauty blenders in the past and greatly regretted it. So I will be linking the beauty blenders that I love. I love these. I got two of them. I love them. They're like $20 for one. So expensive, but it comes with like a little washing thing. Oh, they stay clean as long as you wash them, and they work great. So I'm going to speed up doing this. There's nothing really important to show other than, you know, just if you want to hide certain features, I advise, you know, really getting that foundation going. At least it works for camera. IRL kind of works. Sometimes you look kind of goofy, so be careful with that. Don't forget, you can't really see it right now because we have a pretty bad angle. Don't forget to go underneath your eyes if you're not using concealer. I use my foundation instead of just using concealer. Not a big fan of using concealer and foundation. Make sure to go underneath your eyes and get rid of those dark spots under your eyes. It's really important to lighten up around your eyes. It gives you a much more feminine appearance. So you really want to emphasis on lighting up certain darker spots of your face. And if you're a guy, trying to make your skin look a little bit smoother and making sure your jawline is a little bit less pronounced. You can see already where I put the foundation. My jawline's a little bit less pronounced now because it just kind of blends in. It's a little bit lighter. It's harder to distinguish the shadows. You're kind of just playing with lighting here. This isn't as much as I'd normally like to apply, but I've got to speed through this as I have to go live in 10 minutes. Here, I previously used this little Fit Me. I don't even know. It's like Fit Me foundation powder, kind of. It's really weird. It kind of just helps with sweating. If you have a very oily face, I advise picking up this. This will also be in the description. This is the Fit Me powder. If you have a very oily face, try and get this. I've been on Accutane for a while. My face is no longer very oily or very sweaty. I'm very dry, so I don't really use it anymore. And I just dropped it on the floor. Anyways, up next, I'm going to skip blush entirely because, like I said, I don't need blush, but I'm going to give you my blush recommendations. Here is the blush palette I really, really love. It's really just an eyeshadow palette that I use as blush. What I use for my blush, if you are interested in doing blush, I don't do blush anymore, but if you like blush, blush is so cute. This is what I recommend. Pretty cheap. I don't remember the price, but it's the NYX Ultimate Shadow Palette. You open it up, and what you're going to want to use on this shadow palette here is the top red ones. You grab your blush brush, and you just swipe on the top ones, and then you apply where you want your blush. It works great. I'm not going to be doing blush. I'm not a fan of blush as much as I used to be, but if you want to do blush, This is it. This is it. This is great for blush. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. Eyeliner. Okay. I cannot stress this enough. If you are doing eyeliner, please get a felt tip liquid eyeliner. Do not use that gross pencil stuff. Ah. Okay. Well, I guess it depends on what kind of eyeliner you're doing. But for my e-girl, I guess it's like cat eye eyeliner. I like to use this NYX Epic Ink Liner. This is great. This is amazing. It's so very sexy. I do it. I'm going to try and tell you how to do your eyeliner. I have hooded eyes. If you're like me, I could not find any good advice for people with hooded eyes. And then I saw this one YouTube short. It saved my eyeliner so much better now. If you don't have hooded eyes, you don't need to worry about this. But often I get told as a person with hooded eyes that you have to lift up your eyes and just kind of like go in this area right here and then up. No. Bad, because when you set your face back down to normal, your eyeliner will droop. So now, you know, I figured it out. Anyways, for hooded eyes, pay very close attention to this one. It's great. It's great for eyeliner if you haven't been taught this kind of stuff already. Also, if you are doing your makeup, try not to stretch your face up too much. Try to keep your face rested. I know usually you're like, oh, I gotta get it in the right spots. Be careful with that. The only time I can really justify that is as a person, like again, with hooded eyes. When I'm doing just the top eyelid up and to a certain point, I will raise it. And then I lower, and then for when you're in the corner of your eyes with hooded eyes, you just leave your eye closed and be very careful and just kind of swoop your eyeliner up. That way, when you do it, the way it'll work is you'll have a thicker line going up in this direction. I'll show you really quickly. So normally, bottom middle corner of the eye, all the way across, make sure you try and you do your best to rest your face, tilt the pen, and then go from the corner of your eye up and kind of swoop up into that end of your eyebrow. Then you want to lower your eyelid for hooded eye people and go over and up a little tiny bit. You can't really see. You want to go up a little tiny, tiny bit and then drop your kind of rest your face a little bit. Don't kind of leave your eyelid a little bit down, but not too down. And then you want to make sure you hit kind of the corner, the little slit where your eyelid and top of your little eyebrow meet. And then you go down and connect the lines. And as you can see, actually you can't see. You see, now that I haven't, you know, done it the normal way that people with hooded eyes are taught, you can see that they're disconnected. You can connect those. Now when I rest my face, ready? It looks normal. Normally, if you do this, when you rest your face after, you know, doing this to do your eye, like the hooded eye people are normally told to do it, if you keep your face up like this, when you rest it, your eyeliner will droop. Now my eyeliner is not drooped. So what we're gonna wanna do is we're gonna wanna fill in now. I am gonna connect these really quickly. So we just do a little bit of a, draw a little line to connect it and then fill it in. So now, look at that. Look at that eyeliner. It looks phenomenal. As a person who has hooded eyes, it's great. Because now, look, I look gorgeous with my face rest. So now if I do go like this, you can see that. But this is if you have hooded eyes. You need to do this. Please, please. I'm tired of people teaching it wrong. Because when you rest your eye, this really only works for certain eyeliner types. But for eyeliner types where you're going to be, you know, going off your eye into the side a little bit, this is very important to follow if you have hooded eyes. If you don't, this is probably a little bit easier for you. But I advise keeping your face rested because most of the time you're not going to be walking around like this. So if you're doing your eyeliner off to the side, you're not going to be walking around like this with your eyebrows up all the time. So make sure your face is going to be rested. You do it when your face is rested. Anyways, this is kind of just the final look. This is all I do now. If you want to do blush, like I said, you can. I'm going to give you some quick recommendations for what I do. For freckles, if I want to apply freckles, I will give you my freckle advice. I already told you about my brush. This is my blush. Normally, this is where I do freckles. I'm not a big fan of doing freckles anymore, but I'm going to give you my recommendations for people that want to do freckles. You'll just dot your face where you want the freckles, and I'll give you my makeup recommendations for that. I got these pretty cheap freckle pens that I really like, but I'll say it now. Nothing doesn't like the good old brown Crayola marker, which I no longer have because it went dry. Brown Crayola markers work. Look at us. We already look feminine enough. This is where what I'd do is I'd go around and kind of dab foundation on my neck over those red spots and where I touch up, but I have to, you know, go get ready to stream. So this is just my fast, quick, and easy makeup tutorial and makeup recommendations for people that are learning to do makeup. It's pretty simple. I really advise doing this if you're trying to be very feminine. Also, quick fit check. Check this out. Ready? Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. We got the Lolita fit. I'll see you guys later. Goodbye. Hopefully this helped you. If you have any questions, comment. This is less in depth than my old tutorial, but I learned that I there are better ways to do makeup. You know what they always say, work smarter, not harder. So I've been working a lot smarter and not a lot harder. If you don't get your eyelashes done, mascara. My mascara recommendation is this Voluminous Lash Paradise. That'll be linked in the description. I advise getting your eyelashes done though. It makes a bigger difference. But if you don't, very cool. I'm gonna tell you how to do your mascara because why not? You take it out, you kind of squint your eyes like this. Don't poke yourself! You squint your eyes like this and you go, and then you go like that. Feminization, it's the small things that count. Take care of yourselves. Have a great day. If you have any questions, ask me. I'm sorry that you learned to do makeup from me. Good luck!